Analyzing finance with Nick. As you've noticed, I have significantly upgraded the sound and video quality of these as a gift to my viewers because I always try to make this show better. And hopefully it has become noticeable. Now that move on from that, let's talk about the topic of the day, which is the paradox of thrift. What is the paradox of thrift exactly? Well, to make keep things simple, the paradox of thrift is the idea that while increasing the savings rate may be good on the level of an individual or a family or a business, when it comes to the economy on a macro scale, if everybody increased their savings rate, it would be a disaster. Or to put it in more academic terms, an increased savings rate could be detrimental to economic growth. So where does this idea come from? Well, it comes from John Maynard Keynes and his general theory. And he basically believes that the economy is run essentially by people who live beyond their means. And you need to keep people going further and further beyond their means to promote economic growth, especially if you do not have very rapid population growth or very fast technological innovation. And as a result, he thinks if everybody as a whole decided to save money, then it would hurt the economy. So let me just put this in a more real example. Say, for example, what I do is instead of going out to eat every meal, I decide for a month just to buy groceries and cook them all myself. Maybe my grocery bill is, say, $600 for that month versus me going out to eat every night, which would be probably $20 to $50 a night times 30, which would just say like be about $1,000. So I am saving at least $400 a month going out to eat. Personally, I benefit from that financially. I'll probably also benefit my health, but that really has nothing to do with this channel. However, the economy is hurt by me making that decision. The reason for that is by me keeping that $400 and just saving it, in theory, that money is not going into the economy, because if I spent it at the restaurant, it would go not only to the restaurant owner whose profits finance his or her lifestyle, it doesn't not only to the farmers who and the food suppliers who supply him his food, but also goes to all the wait staff at that restaurant and all the cooks whose wages are based on people like me going to eat at their establishments. It also goes to the landlord who is collecting the rents on that restaurant. And by me not attending, that is money out of their pockets. And since it's money out of their pockets, they can't spend it or save it for their own purposes. And so if I do it as one person, it's not that noticeable, and it will help my personal finances quite a bit. But let's just say everybody in my town decides to do that. Well, every restaurant would go out of business overnight if everybody decided to shop at home for an entire month. It would be the equivalent of like having the lockdown in 2020. That is the paradox of thrift in its glory. However, I question the idea of the paradox of thrift is really as strong as we see it to be, because for me, saving, that doesn't necessarily mean that that money is not being put to use. Say, for example, if I save and put my money in a bank, then that bank, in theory, should at least be lending that money out to borrowers who will be using it as means to grow the economy, whether it's small businesses who are borrowing for small business loans or somebody getting a mortgage for a house. So my savings is increasing the capital stock that can be used or investments. Or if I don't put it in the bank, I put it in my brokerage account and buy stocks with it. In theory, I am helping finance the growth of larger companies and be able to, in the future, raise money at more favorable valuations to use for capital expenditures. So I don't necessarily think that by me saving and being more responsible is hurting the economy, because again, I can do help the economy grow as an investor instead of as a consumer. That is the main counterargument to the paradox of thrift. Other counterarguments really to the paradox of thrift would be that if you spend beyond your means and get into debt, then paying that interest is money lost out of the system. And I'm going to do a future video about how debt affects inflation. I did record one originally, but I want to do it on a better quality sound platform, so I'm going to redo it. But the point being is that if you're having to spend money to pay on interest payments instead of being able to save that money or just use that for other purposes, that's money that's going out of the economy. Paying interest is partially contracting the money, and paying down debt is contracting the money supply, because the expansion of credit is the main driver for the expansion of money supply. I mean, there is the central bank printing and stuff, but that is all impacted by the money multiplier effect from lending. And so paying down debt is negative lending in a sense. So that's the other really counter argument against the paradox of thrift. So I think really the paradox of thrift makes the most sense, not on the micro level, not on the macro level, but on the mid level, like the restaurant example. Say if everybody in a town decides to save money or shift a spending habit, that would destroy a business. But on the macro level, is that going to sink the entire country's economy? No, especially if that capital is put to other uses, either it's spent somewhere else or used to finance projects through increased savings. The one other argument, though, really that might help the paradox of thrift is if you're in an economy that is mature and there is a lack of projects to finance. And that arguably may be why interest rates are as low as they are now outside of central bank intervention, is because there is a lack of safe assets out there that can be bought, and there are a lack of projects that for relative to the excess savings in the economy due to inequality and demographics of retirement and et cetera. So maybe paradox of thrift makes sense in an economy with excess savings, whereas it doesn't make sense in an economy without excess savings. Well, that concludes my thoughts on the paradox of thrift. Like and subscribe if you like what we're doing, and I will see you next time.